Hello guys. This is the third video of MacBook. In this video, you're going to learn how PP3V42G3H voltage in SMC underscore reset underscore L signal get generated and review where they are used. And as the voltage and the signal are very important in MacBook devices, I hope you keep watching until the end of the video. I can say that PP3V42G3H voltage is the most important voltage that's generated in MacBook devices. Why is it the most important? As I said in the previous video, charging IC and SMC need PP3V42G3H for generating PPBUS reference voltage, also to drive themselves. So if PP3V42G3H would be absent or it would be low or high, it would have a huge effect on the device's performance. Briefly, many voltages and signals that we deal with in MacBook devices somehow need this voltage. As you see, according to the voltages renaming table, the voltage enters different components with different names, and the important ones are charging IC and SMC. And if the voltage gets absent, RTC circuit won't work, and even the adapter communicates with the device using this voltage in a specific process, which I'll talk about in the next videos. And if this voltage wouldn't be present, adapter can't communicate with the device, because this is one of the main necessary voltages of one-wire circuit, which is the link between adapter and device. You can see where the voltage is consumed by checking power aliases page and tracking the names that change in each block on schematics, and realize its importance. As you see, this voltage pulls up many signals, which are essential for the board to turn on and work. You can see some of the signals in this table. For example, power key signal gets pulled up by with voltage. And in case this signal doesn't get pulled up, the device can't detect when the power key was pressed, and other stuff that you can realize by checking schematic. For example, the important signal, ACOK, that's pulled up by this voltage, which I've talked about in the previous video. Another feature of this voltage is its independence, meaning, the IC that generates this voltage doesn't need any controller's confirmation for generating this voltage, and it starts generating this voltage as soon as it receives its intended voltage, while most other ICs or controllers receive enable command from another controller IC or control circuit to start working. And when their enable pin gets activated, they start performing their duties. But the IC that generates PP3V42G3H voltage doesn't need enable command from anywhere and will work independent from other blocks of the system, which I'll talk about more in the following. According to the surveys we have done, 99% of all devices use these three ICs for generating this voltage: PM6640, LT3470A and LTC1871 ICs, and each of them has its own specific specification that I'm going to talk about. At first I'm going to analyze how they work, and then, as input voltage of this IC might be sent from battery or adapter, You're going to see the ways that it gets provided for this IC. The first one is PM6640 IC. This 11-pinned IC has a small PWM circuit inside it. At first, the input voltage that can be sent from device's battery or adapter enters pin VIN, TUN and enable pins. This means by entering voltage to VIN pin, the IC starts working. Though I should say that I'm not going to analyze how this IC works. And those who like to have more information can refer to its datasheet. I'm going to explain a little. When IC receives voltage from VIN pin, and when enable pin gets activated by that exact voltage, the IC generates VCC voltage and sends it to its FB pin. And as this voltage is connected to GND by a capacitor, this voltage will have a slight delay, which will cause a slight delay on output of IC. And IC will use its internal PWM technology and will start generating a voltage that exits through its SW pin. And that voltage will get stabilized after passing an inductor and reaches to 3.42 volts, which is PP3V42_G3H voltage. And IC uses voltage bypass to solve error of its output, which, as you see, it is connected to bypass pin. Since this is one of the mostly used ICs for generating PP3V42_G3H voltage, I've explained a bit so that you'll know how this IC works. The next IC is LTC1871, which is rarely used. One of the features of this IC is that it's used in voltage booster circuits, and it raises the input voltage instead of lowering it. But in this platform that I'm working on, after boosting input voltage in a process, the boosted voltage gets lowered until it gets to 3.42 volts. As you see, adapter battery input voltage enters VIN pin of IC. And as I said before, it gets this voltage to the intended value, which is 3.42 volts. In a specific process, the important point in this way of generating 3.42 volts is that this IC realizes the value of its output voltage according to the ohm value of two resistors. You can see the two resistors on this slide. And this is the calculation formula. Output voltage equals 1.23 asterisk, the sum of 1 plus the division of resistance value of Ra and Rb, 1.230 volts asterisk, 1 plus Ra divided by Rb, which you can see on the picture, as Ra is 191 kilo ohm in this circuit, and Rb is 107 kilo ohm. The quotient of these two is around 1.785, and sum of that number with 1 multiplied by 1.23 equals to 3.42 V, which is the output voltage. The conclusion is that, if voltage was dropped or low on PP3V42_G3H voltage circuit, only if LTC1871 IC was used for providing this voltage, and you were sure that this IC is okay, you need to check ohm of these two resistors, because they have important roles in changing output voltage value of this circuit. The next IC that is used for generating PP3V42_G3H voltage is LT3470AIC. As you see on this slide.